Once both our management and gateways have been connected to the portal, we may go ahead and create the actual SD-WAN policy. We'll notice here it's initially empty, and so we will go here and open the SD-WAN wizard, which will give us the basis for the policy creation with default rules and steering behaviors, and will guide us in the process for doing so. We can see here the relevant blades needed, and then we will proceed on. Here, you may select from the out-of-the-box use cases that have been defined as per the field, and select what is relevant for you. Also notice the checkbox available for filter based on internet or overlay VPN needs. This can be a starting point, and later, more rules and behaviors may be added manually as needed. Next, we will select the gateways which we wish to enforce on our SD-WAN policy, and here we'll select all the relevant gateways. Here, we have what we call the WAN Link Mapping. This enables us to pair the relevant interfaces, up on top, to the relevant link based on the information that has been defined in our gateways. This is initially selected as per the order defined, but may be changed accordingly. Lastly, once this is all done, we will generate the policy. Here, we'll do so without publishing or enforcing, so we may first go ahead and review it. And then, later, once reviewed and decided upon, we may publish and enforce when ready. Here, we see the rule base has actually been created, and we see, you know, the different information, of course, based on what we've chosen. We have, like we said, the different steering behaviors here, and once ready, we may go ahead and enforce. Thank you.